Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and in this particular video I'll be talking about a library called NumPy, which is also known as Numerical Python. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. NumPy is a library which helps you calculate or perform all the mathematical functions on the data structures which are not possible when you have only a data structure available to you. So for example, I have a list L1 equals to 1 2 3 4, and I have another list that is L2 again 1 2 3 4, so for simplicity, and we are storing it in a variable A. Once we multiply these two lists, that is L1 multiplied by L2, and we print the result, we get an error here. You see, we get an error. Can't multiply sequence by non-integer of type list. So basically, list cannot be multiplied with each other. If you have watched my previous video, I have discussed few concepts of how lists are made and how you can add the list and subtract the list from each other and all that. If you haven't watched my previous videos, please click on the I button on the top right hand side corner of your screen so that you can go ahead and watch that video. I'll just give you a small example here that suppose if I want to concatenate, if I want to add these two lists, what it does is it concatenates instead of adding 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, 3 plus 3, 4 plus 4. If I subtract, it is again going to give us an error. So only plus sign works, and that too, it only appends our values. So here comes in the working of NumPy library. What it particularly does is it creates a matrix kind of a situation wherein you are able to multiply values on the index basis, but keep in mind that matrix multiplication is completely different. It just and NumPy matrix are completely different. NumPy matrices just help you match or multiply one value from another with the help of indexes, and in original matrix multiplication, we all know that the row is multiplied by both the columns and likewise. So this is not the case. NumPy does not directly support matrix multiplication in mathematical terms. It supports data multiplication on the index basis. So let's check out how it happens. Now first, what we are going to do is we are going to import our library, that is import NumPy as np, and after that we are going to use np.array method, np.array l1, and we are going to place that previous list in the brackets of this array method. Now if you ask what is array, as I said, array can be array is nothing but one dimensional, two dimensional vector or a matrix formation, or a three-dimensional data which makes a plane or like that. So we are just creating matrices in that respect. If there is a single value, that means multiple rows and a single column, in that case it's a vector, otherwise it's a matrix. We are only going by the concept, we are not actually in maths. Remember that while using this so that you are not confused. So here we have np.array l1 stored in a1, and np.array again used to change this list into an array b1. Run this line. Now we'll get the result as, if we print a1, we'll get array and this format, and if we print b1, we will get this in this format. Now all we need to do is multiply a1 into b1. So a1 multiplied by b1 is again an array, that is 1 4 9 16, right? And That's it. So we have 1 1s are 1, 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9, and 4 4s are 16. So we have multiplied these two lists, which was not possible in list format, but we did it in the array format. Now let's check out how to create two-dimensional array, or you can say a matrix kind of a format. So here we have, one more thing, we can also create a list, we can also create an array directly by using the list inside this particular method. So instead of using the variable that was L1 and L2, we are going to use brackets 1, 2, 3, list np.array. We can also use tuple as well. And we can also use a dictionary. Here we have A, 1, B, 2 and C, 3. So now let's create two-dimensional array. So for two-dimensional array, we all remember that we create list of lists. So in that way only we are going to create a list of lists so that we are able to create two-dimensional array. So here we have 1, 2, 3, this is the for bracket 1, this one, and in this particular list we are creating two separate lists. So 1, 2, 3, this is second list, and then we have comma 4, 5, 6 as my third list, and this is enclosed in the first list. Once we run that, we get a structure like this, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that is kind of a matrix format. If we store this in a variable A, and let's copy this again, and then multiply this A and B, and let's see what happens. So now we get a matrix multiplication, not a matrix multiplication, but the indices multiplication in this regard. So 1 multiplied by 1, 2 multiplied by 2, and 3 multiplied by 3. 3 multiplied by 3 in this regard. Okay. Now, here we have 4 multiplied by 4, 5 multiplied by 5, 6 multiplied by 6. So you can see that the indexes are multiplying. Common indexes are multiplying. So if we add this, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 8, 3 plus 3, 6, 4 plus 4, 8, 5 plus 5, 10, and 6 plus 6, 12. Subtracting each of them will give us 0, obviously, because we have same values in both the mount the errors. Now same thing can be done with the help of tuple. So we can create tuple within a tuple, and then we can create a 2D array. Now since you have understood the meaning of what array is in particular, let's talk about a very important module in NumPy, that is random. So random module has specific methods for specific task, that is creating, but with a single objective, that is creating or generating random data. But what sort of random data you want to generate, that depends on the method you are using. So for a method like rand, a rand method helps you create uniformly distributed data. Here we have look at the process or the way in which my this code is written. So I have used np for my numpy dot random, that is the module, dot the function inside that module. So rand, we have rand. So rand method, what it does, it gives you numbers between 0 and 1, but that is random numbers are generated between 0 and 1. Okay, now so here I have now uniformly distributed number means that each value between 0 and 1, each number has an equal probability to be selected for a sample. So here I have 2 is to 2, that means 2 rows and 2 columns ka data generated and stored in a variable A, and we are printing it as like this. So we have 0.73, 0.06 and so on and so forth, but nothing is beyond 1, so you'll only get values between 0 and 1. Okay, now when it comes to another method, that is random n. Okay, so random n or rand n method, what it does is it generates number between minus 3 to plus 3, that is it generates number of from a normally distributed data. So we have random n and we are generating 30 values. So you can write the data in matrix format, that is 2 rows and 2 columns, so it's quite obvious that we need 4 values to be generated, and here I am directly writing the value. So if I write 30 comma 30, then it will give me 30 rows and 30 columns ka data. So that's that. Now what I am doing here is A equals to np dot random dot rand n 30, and I am printing this. Don't look at the quotes above and below right now. Okay, once we write that and we use 30 here, we get a data like this. So if you look at the data, you see that the values range between minus and plus, but no value is going beyond minus 3, or you can say the maximum value can go beyond you can say that the value can be beyond minus 3, but not that much, like 6.79 or something, minus 6.79 or plus 6.79. It can be closer to minus 3 point something, but it is not going to be way beyond. So we have 0.5, but the maximum value is minus 3.13 and not anything above that. Okay, now when I say normally distributed data, which it basically means that we are talking about a bell-shaped curve. Okay, when a bell shape, when you plot a graph or plot a data, it forms a bell. So in that case, the mean is equal to median, median is equal to mode. If you haven't watched, I have explained in detail what a Gaussian distribution or normal distribution is. So if you haven't watched that video, please go ahead and watch that video to get a clear understanding. So yeah, so here I have, so we are picking up the data from normally distributed values. So but the problem here is some people understand it like that if we are generating normally distributed data, or we are getting the values between minus 3 and plus 3, we will also get a bell-shaped curve, which is not true. We are deriving the data from random values from the normally distributed data. So technically it is not going to give us a bell shaped curve. Instead it is going to give us a curve that is going up and down, like above and below, like this, and not normally distributed, right? So yeah, in case if you build an histogram, so suppose I take this A value and I build it in a histogram format. So plt dot hist A, it is going to look somewhat like this. So we are generating values from normally distributed data. We are technically not creating a normal distribution data. It can be a chance by chance reason that you get a normally distributed data, but generally it doesn't happen because there is a random element involved in it. Okay. So the codes for this particular explanation of NumPy is in my blog, so you can go ahead and click on the link in the description box, and you'll be able to get the codes of these this particular session or video here. So the next one is, we have randint method. Now randint method, what it does, it generates random values, numbers between a particular range, that is here in this case it is 10 to 50, so, and the total number of values which we want. So it gives us integers instead of the decimal values. So here we have random np.random.randint 10, 50, 10, and we are printing this a value. So at the end we are getting a result 10, 30, 16, 15, 27, 38. If I run this again, my data will change, because the number of times you change the value, run these codes, then again it will start generating new data set or new values. So that's that. So that's it for this video. Hope you got some knowledge about what NumPy is and what array is. If you want to learn more from DexLab Analytics or from me regarding this NumPy library or any other library or in Python in particular, you can contact us at you can go ahead and click on the website www.dexlabanalytics.com, or you can call us on the numbers given on the screen. You can also WhatsApp us on the numbers on the screen. The WhatsApp icon is right here. You can also mail us at hello@dexlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. So yeah, bye bye, take care, have a nice day.